this Friday morning.
Join us for a very special Right Royal lineup. Charles and Diana have their Right to Reply at 7. At 8, the Miss Victoria pageant. Then at 9, the powerful conclusion to A Thousand Skies. A Night to Remember on 7.
This program is brought to you by Carlton, brewers of Foster's Lager, Australia's favourite beer.
Born in the valley and raised in the trees of Western Kentucky on wobbly knees, with Mama beside you to help you along, you'll soon be a growing up strong. All the long lazy mornings in pastures of green, the sun on your withers, the wind in your mane, will never prepare you for what lies ahead. The run for the roses so red, and it's a run for the roses as fast as you can. Your fate is delivered, your moment's at hand. It's the chance of a lifetime, in a lifetime of chance. And it's high time you joined in the dance. It's high time you joined. Sire, it's born in the blood, the fire of a mare and the strength of a stud. It's breeding and it's training and it's something unknown that drives you and carries you on.
Three lengths in front. Vanderham now coming hard. Stocker riding for dear life. Battleheart's getting up on the fence, but Houndour's won the cup. Ming Dynasty raced to the lead in the cup with Salamander running on well. But Ming Dynasty's going to win the Caulfield Cup by about a length. Silver Bounty's the danger, coming home hard. No fear in front, but Silver Bounty's grabbing him quickly. It's no fear in Silver Bounty. They're hitting the line together. Silver Bounty, Dunbar's, and Gurner's Lane's going to score a big win in the Caulfield Cup.
Today, the day of the thoroughbred, Caulfield Cup Day, the Foster's Caulfield Cup, worth $500,000. Thank you for joining us in this telecast live and exclusive to Channel 7, and the telecast for the big hour today, going right throughout Australia and internationally as well. The crowd is teeming in, the weather has cleared after a poor morning in which we had some rain. The skies have now cleared, the clouds have drifted away, the crowd is coming in, and the candidates in the first race in the program on Caulfield Cup Day are in the mounting enclosure. And now it's time to say a very good afternoon to our experts, Roy Higgins and Keith Hillier.
Thank you, Bill, and down in the mounting out here, it is bathed in sunshine at the moment. The clouds that you mentioned are very high. We may get a rain-free afternoon, let us hope so. Well, the Caulfield Cup worth $500,000. What a fantastic prize money for a fantastic race. And the race today, the most open in my memory. Joining me, Roy Higgins, 11 times Premier Jockey of Victoria. Roy, of course, won a Caulfield Cup. It was a controversial cup. That was on
Big Baloo,
who beat Desori. Yeah, we'll talk about that later, Roy.
Exactly right. But what a magnificent day it is, Keith. It's a big crowd here today. Not only do we have the $1 million Caulfield Cup, we also have the 1,000 guineas and also one of the heats of the Brill Cream Sprint. And for viewers at home, the track, It should not affect any horses, although I do anticipate possibly horses out about three wide from the home turn will have a slight advantage over the horses on the inside.
Well, at this very moment, the most important race on the program is the first, the Merson Cooper Stakes. Let's have a look now at the opening tote call for race one, the Merson Cooper Stakes, a Group 3 race with prize money of $30,000. The Blaccato, number one, showing 10.15 the win. Three, Come Out Fighting, $17.35. Four, Crescent on $14.95. Five, Dead of Night, $10.65. Six, Mr. Chew, $20.30. Seven, Oyster Bar, $50.15. Eight, Priceless Prince, $28.60. Nine, Red Duke, $63.25. One of the two favourites is number 10, Roman Laurel, now showing $1.35, has firmed. Number 11 is Squatters Green on $6.95 the win. 12, Suave Sovereign, $24.05. 13, Wheat Sheaf Road, $5.35. 14, Bell Landy, $112.50. 15, She Flies, $1.25 and 70 cents a place. And number 16, Sparkling Effect, showing $78.30 the win. Scratchings for the afternoon are light. In the first, number two, Claws, who was one of the early favourites, is the only withdrawal. From race two, take out number six, Hot Case, and number 15, Human Nature. Move on then to the Cup, where we take out the emergencies, number 19, Fox Seal, and number 20, Tripsicum. Race six, scratch 10, Grey Khan, 14, Crime of Passion, and 15, Ollie's Decree. Race seven, scratch number nine, Sparkle Free, and from the last, only one scratching, number four, Great Poet.
We'll have go on with it as he did.
This is Cena Bendigo, the field taking shape now for race one, the maiden, 1600 metres.
Starter on his rostrum.
Starter on his rostrum. Lights on. He's Bendigo.
All set. Three or four, very fidgety. One nearly got rid of the rider there, just towards the outside. Attendance in with about three or four. Better line, they said, and they're off. A little bit slow to begin was Ripolani, along with Countess Abba, and also Our Seraphim dropped out to the tail with Lucinda Bay. Best to begin was Our Seraphim, doesn't want to lead though. Norwegian Girl going forward with Torment inside the 1400. In behind them came Roshana. A length and a half away, Daryl's Dove now racing to third and wide. In behind them, Bonnie Artis, followed by High Loom. Two and a half away back in the field is Will Tell, followed by Ripolani, Joe Nella, Countess Abba, Quit the Club, Lucinda Bay. And a length and a half away, Our Seraphim last and racing very wide. Along the side, though, 1,000 metres to go. There'd be 20 lengths covering the field, and Torment in front had got away by two lengths to Norwegian Girl in the box seat and working up as Daryl's Dove. Three lengths away, Lindale misses fourth. A length and a half away, Roshana. In behind them, two lengths away, Bonnie Artis, followed by High Loom. Will Tell as well back, followed by Ripolani, Quit the Club, Jonella, Countess Abba, and two lengths away, Lucinda Bay. And now Seraphim about to be pulled up before the turn, though, 600 metres to go. Torment at the moment, a half in front, being hard ridden from Daryl's Dove, and Lindale Miss now hooked to the outside. She's coming at them very quickly. Norwegian Girl in behind them going okay, in need of a run. Two lengths away, Roshana. Hooked to the outside, Bonnie Artis, Lucinda Bay well back, followed by High Loom. In the straight though, 300 metres to go, and the favourite now, Lindale Miss, had raced to the lead by a length and a half to Torment. Norwegian Girl on the outside boxing on, Quit the Club from well back as making ground with Jonella down the outside. At the 120, Lindale Miss in front, she's getting very wary. Torment coming again on the inside with Quit the Club, and Jonella wider out is flying. Quit the Club grabbed the lead near the line from Jonella, flashing through, and Quit the Club has won a neck to Jonella. A half away, Torment third. Lindale must stop badly in the straight from Ripolani, Lucinda Bay. In behind them came Norwegian Girl, followed by Bonnie Artist, then High Loom, followed by Ripolani. Back in behind them came Roshana, followed by Will Tell, then Daryl's Dove.
But it looked like 15, 11 and 12 in the first at Bendigo. The winner there, Quit the Club. We'll have confirmation on those placings soon. But more importantly, he's our caller for the day, Bill Collins, with the first from Caulfield.
And they're moving in quite well for the first event on the card. Now, Suave Sovereign has gone into line. Blaccato wider out on the track. And Mr. Chew has taken up its place. Bell Landy walking up towards the line and goes in. Rider climbing into the saddle. Getting settled. Weather absolutely perfect now.
Sparkling Effect getting toey on the inside. Lights on. They stand. Racing. And they've jumped away pretty well. She flies away all right. Roman Laurel got away fairly well today, and out wide are Wheat Chief Road and Blacato showing speed. She flies and Blacato led on settling down a length. The Roman Laurel is up third today. Squatters Green the outside from Dead of Night and Crescent. Then Red Duke, Wheat Chief Road, followed by Suave Sovereign back behind those horses with Oyster Bar, and then came Come Out Fighting. Priceless Prince is well back as they neared the turn from Sparkling Effect and Bell Landy and last Mr. Shoe. She flies the leader on the inside of the corner, led about a half and kicked away now, two lengths into the straight. From in second placing is Blacato, and there followed now by Roman Laurel, a length and a half away, getting into the clear, followed by Squatters Green and Crescent, but she flies well clear, 200 to go. The filly trying to make it three in a row, Roman Laurel trying to cut her down on the outside, but Morn hands and heels on She Flies, still a length in front, he's had to go for the whip. Roman Laurel won't pick it up though, three starts for three wins to She Flies. Roman Laurel second, third Crescent, then came Squatters Green, next Dead of Night, Blacato, Wheat Chief Road, Priceless Prince and Oyster Bar, then Red Duke, Suave Sovereign was next, further back is Sparkling Effect, Come Out Fighting, well back in the field is Bell Landy and last to finish Mr. Chu. Official placings for the Merson Cooper Stakes, the Group 3 race, first event on Caulfield Cup Day, the winner number 15, She Flies, ridden by El Morn. Number 15, She Flies. El Morn first. Number 10, Roman Laurel. El Dittman second. And number 4, Crescent, ridden by M. Gorham, was third. 15, 10 and 4. Stakes number 15, She Flies. Three starts for three wins. She Flies is a bay filly by Nuclear Power from Miss Tanith. Raced by F.L. Burnett, R.S. Dixon, D.J. Lay and M.T. James and Mrs. J. Duncan, trained by Ron Morn at Ballarat and ridden by his son, apprentice Len Morn. Second was number 10, Roman Laurel, L. Dittman. Third, number 4, Crescent, M. Gorham. Officially fourth was Squatters Green, and fifth in the race, number 5, Dead of Night. $52.80 for the first trifecta here today at Caulfield. The crowd building up. There are plenty of cars still streaming into the course, and I think we're going to have a very good crowd here today for the Caulfield Cup. And as I mentioned, the track I feel certain will be upgraded by the stewards within a very short space of time. With
the 66 Cup, when unplaced, was once again the choice of the punters. The little horse with the big heart took the lead with 3 furlongs to run, and with Jimmy Johnson wielding the whip in vigorous fashion, Tobin Bronze got there with 9 stone 10, the second highest weight ever carried to victory in the Caulfield Cup. 1 week later, he was to win the Cox Plate in his farewell Australian appearance.
And so the result of the first race with correct weight up, and the favourite won it. 15 She Flies, 3 in a row out of 3 starts. 1. 2.50 and third 11 Torment, $1.15. Quinella and Bendigo, $66.75. The trifecta, $2,216.30.
Well, now the second, it's a 1600 metre second maiden. Incidentally, just recapping on Jenny Chapman's tips here, race 2 at Caulfield. Jenny selected to win number 4 Slave Trade ahead of 8, which is Insatiate, and her third selection was 10 Federalism. And we have about 5 minutes before race starting time here at Caulfield. That, of course, means 5 minutes of betting time with your phone accounts or at your TAB agency. The Bendigo runner's now moving into the stalls, so we'll join our caller
line
at Bendigo.
Race two, the light's on, the starter on his platform. First division of the maiden handicap. All set. Good line. Stand by for a start for race two, Bendigo. Over 1,600 metres, the favourite out of the bag, well tried. Set on their racing,
Out of the bag, jumped fairly well. Pelliarchy missed it by 3/4, and Lansfield Lad drops out to a conspicuous last. Flying Nawab began quickly. It's looking for the lead and taking over on settling down. From Arcturus going forward and out of the bag and back on the rail is Jill Fame. Then off the track, King Toby going forward, followed by Ocean Voyage and Sir Barkus. A length away, Laurenti Lad, followed by Pelliarchy Ruling Hun. 2 lengths away, Just a Sudden Neutrino, and 4 lengths away, Lansfield Lad. Near in 1,000-metre peg and Flying Norb in front by a half to King Toby. A neck on the inside is out of the bag in the box seat. A length and a half away, Sir Barkus racing wide as they make a line of 3 900 metres out. In behind them, Jill Fame, followed by Ocean Voyage. 2 lengths away, Laurenti Lad. In behind them, Arcturus not going well, followed by Just a Sudden Ruling Hun, Pelliarchy, Wellback Neutrino, and 2 lengths away, Lansfield Lad. At the 650 and on the outside, King Toby draws a neck in front of out of the bag being hard ridden. A neck on the inside, Flying Norb. A length and a half away, Ocean Voyage, followed by Jill Fame. Then Sir Barkus, followed by Laurenti Lad going forward. Wellback as Neutrino, followed by Just a Sudden Arcturus Ruling Hun, Pelliarchy, and 2 lengths away, Lansfield Lad. Around the turn though, 400 metres to go. Out of the bag in the centre draws a neck in front of Lying Norb coming again. King Toby wide around, followed by Laurenti Lad joining in very quickly. At the 200 metres though, and Laurenti Lad now quickly moved up on the outside, draw a length in front of Flying Norb, followed by Out of the Bag who can't go on. Just a Soda getting to second is making ground. At the 100 though, Laurenti Lad 3/4 in front. Just a Soda on the outside is picking it up. Laurenti Lad a neck in front. Laurenti Lad is hanging on, and Laurenti Lad has got home 3/4 to Just a Soda. Tight for third, Jill Fame and Arcturus. Then Ocean Voyage, Out of the Bag, Neutrino, Ruling Hun. Back in behind them, Flying Norb, followed by Pelliarchy.
Well, the winner at Bendigo, number 9, but that scene on camera is a scene from behind the 1,200-metre barrier here at Caulfield, where the three-year-old Colts and Geldings are milling, and it won't be long before they're called into line for race 2. The Mercedes-Benz, as I mentioned, it is the first leg of the Melbourne Extra Double.
Balls and set. Field settling. Light. Racing. All Slave Trade knuckled at the start, but didn't lose much ground just the same. And Daylight has begun quite well in Insatiate, going fast with Swift Vixen, and Slave Trade booting up with Green Action towards the leaders. When they settle down, Federalism out wide on the track and Mighty Remington going through on the rails. At the 800, Slave Trade had gone up the join. Swift Vixen 2 lengths to Mighty Remington, followed by Broquillo. They were followed by Annunciate. In that bunch of horses was Prince Gaylord, also at this stage with Green Action. Federalism is further back in the field, then followed by Centenarian Cara's Luck. Insatiate's gone back there, I think, to second last at this stage, and Rhoda Rouge has tailed off last. Near the corner, Swift Vixen the leader, a half-length Slave Trade. Green Action making its run on the outside. Mighty Remington trying to get up on the rails, and then Daylight around them from Broquillo, badly boxed in. In the straight, Swift Vixen joined by Slave Trade. Cassidy looks over his shoulder. Slave Trade now takes the lead. Coming at him, Green Action, and then Mighty Remington, but Slave Trade in front with 100 to go. Federalism with a very late run out wide. Slave Trade in front. Federalism flying on the outside. He might grab him. Federalism grabs it on the line, and Federalism wins it from Slave Trade. Green Action third from Mighty Remington, and they were followed by Daylight, Swift Vixen, Broquillo. Then Annunciate. Further back, Cara's Luck, followed by Prince Gaylord. Back behind them again, Rhoda Rouge, and then Centenarian, and last home was Insatiate. Official placings for the second event, the Mercedes-Benz. Number 10 is the winner, Federalism, ridden by G. Willits. Number 10, Federalism, G. Willits first. Number 4, Slave Trade, ridden by J. Cassidy second. And the judges call for a photo for third placing with Green Action on the outside and over on the inside, Mighty Remington. Green Action will get third without any shadow of doubt. Slave Trade looked home. He knuckled at the start but didn't lose any ground of any account. Might have lost a neck or so. Mercedes-Benz. Number 10, Federalism by Vice Regal from Mary Mead. A Bay Colt raced by MJ Reed, PJ and PM Vila, now trained by TL Millard and ridden by Gary Willits. Second, number 4, Slave Trade, J. Cassidy. And third, number 7, Green Action, ridden by G. Mather. Officially fourth was number 12, Mighty Remington. And fifth, number 11, Daytime. For a win to 10, Federalism, $4.10 and $1.45.
5.
Second, 4 Slave Trade, the favourite, 80. And third, 7 Green Action, $1.65. The Quinella paid $7.35. The Trifecta, not yet available. Ladies and gentlemen. $1.65, the Quinella $7.35, and the Trifecta paid $304 even.
So Dean, it's the favourite, 4, proudly bold, showing $3.45. The other two in the market are number 7, 4 Dice, at $1.35, and number 13 is showing $5.45. That's Camden Fury. There was a late scratching at Bendigo, number 8, Damasus, it came out of there, and also there is a delay because one of the horses at Bendigo has got loose, Roy, and this might mean a delay of a minute and a half or at least that, and they're chasing the horse now.
They've actually caught the horse, but it has to be examined by a vet, and they're looking at it now, so the race will possibly be delayed.
Massive man into the stall. The rest of the field appears to be set, so we'll join our caller at Bendigo.
Massive man is in, starter on his platform, and we're all set for the third. Again, over 1,600 metres. They're all in. We're standing by for the light. Looks okay, they said, and they're racing. White out, classic move began quickly with 4 Dice and Camden Fury. In behind them now, Dancer's Bid, followed by King of Pain. 3/4 away, proudly bold, followed by Orchestra Man, Stray Prince, and Massive Man Researching, and 4 lengths away down the line. At the 1,300, Camden Fury works up on the outside and draws a length now to 4 Dice, is taking the trail. A length and a half away, proudly bold, pulling on the inside of King of Pain. 2 lengths away, classic move. He's close enough, if good enough, nearing the 1,000, followed by Dancer's Bid. In behind them, Stray Prince, followed by Orchestra Man. Massive Man well back, 2.5 away, researching, and 4 lengths away down the line. Inside the 1,000, Camden Fury broke away. He's going quickly by 2.5 to 4 Dice in the box seat. A length and a half away, King of Pain, a neck on the inside, proudly bold. In behind them, classic move. He's still close enough, followed by Stray Prince, is going forward. In behind them, Orchestra Man, followed by Massive Man, hooked to the outside. Then researching, Dancer's Bid, and 5 lengths away down the line. He can't get warm at the moment. Before the turn, though, 600 metres out, it's still Camden Fury over length in front of 4 Dice, is going okay and about to be called upon. He joins Camden Fury on the turn at the 450. Stray Prince out, wider out, makes a line of 3. Classic move now, called upon. He's hooked to the outside, followed by Proudly Bold. Then King of Pain, well back as Orchestra Man. At the 250, though, and 4 Dice had bounded away. He went straight past Camden Fury, set up 2 lengths at the 200. The only danger, classic move, if any, followed by Stray Prince, and then Proudly Bold, followed by Orchestra Man. 4 Dice at the 120 is 2 lengths in front. Classic move is slowly bridging the gap. 4 Dice, though, hanging on near the line, and 4 Dice has got home a length and a half to classic move. 3 lengths away, third was Proudly Bold, then Orchestra Man, Stray Prince, Camden Fury, down the line beat a few home, Massive Man, King of Pain researching, and last in was Dancer's Bid.
Field stands, they settle, the lights on. No, a bit of movement. They're racing now, and near the inside, Centuria began well from Mokopan. Bev Rose and Ivana stopped snoozing and then quite on the outside. When they settle down, Bev Rose has worked its way to the lead from Centuria being eased behind it. On the outside, Digger's Lass is going quickly towards the leaders with quite and Ivana, and then came Sasha's Mrs. Fitzherbert. 2 lengths further back in the field is Mokopan, and they are followed by Christmas Hamper. Then Crystal Springs is behind those horses from Lady Ivel, Comarina and Perlek. Over the 1200 hill, and the leader is Bev Rose, a length to Digger's Lass, a length and a half Mrs. Fitzherbert. Stop snoozing is with those horses, and on the inside, centre rear in the box seat. 2 lengths to Quite, a length and a half further back then came Sashes from Ivana, who's lost its position. Christmas Hamper now taken to the outside from Mokopan, and then Lady Ivel, Comarina, followed by Crystal Springs and Perlek. 800 to go, Bev Rose only a neck in front of Digger's Lass, and a length to Mrs. Fitzherbert, a half to centre rear on the inside, then a half to Sashes. Christmas Hamper's coming with a big run around the outside. Ivana is trying to follow it from Stop Snoozing. Mokopan and Quite's going poorly. On the corner, 400 out, Bev Rose, Digger's Lass, and now Mrs. Fitzherbert. Centre rear is pocketed by Christmas Hamper around the outside, and then Sasha's Ivana and Mokopan. Into the straight, Mrs. Fitzherbert's taken the lead from Digger's Lass and Bev's Rose. Christmas Hamper made the turn badly. Centre rear gets out now. It's Mrs. Fitzherbert in front. Centre rear running to it now. Ivana coming home late on the outside, but little Mrs. Fitzherbert won't give in.
Centre rear can't get to it. Mokapan's running on well at the finish. But Mrs. Fitzherbert striding away to win by 2.5 lengths to Centre rear. Third Mokapan, fourth Havana, then Christmas Hamper, Digger's Last Quite. Next Sashes, followed by Perlack, Lady Ivel, Comarina. Further back is Bevrose, and last to finish, Stop Snoozing.
Official placings in the Stubby Stakes. Race 3 on the Caulfield Cup Day program. Number 2, Mrs. Fitzherbert, ridden by D. Gauchy, was first. Number 2, Mrs. Fitzherbert, D. Gauchy first. Number 1, Centuria, W. Trelaw second. And number 5, Mokapan, ridden by P. Highland, was third. 2, 1, and 5. Number 2, Mrs. Fitzherbert, a chestnut mare 5-year-old by Lord Dudley from Very Vane, raced by Madames P. Churnside, H. Hyder and J. Wilson, trained by Colin Hayes and ridden by Darren Gauchy. Second, number 1, Centuria, W. Trelaw, and third, number 5, Mokapan, P. Highland. Officially fourth was Havana and fifth, Christmas Hamper. So, candidates come back to scale. Mrs. Fitzherbert to pay $2.05.95. Centuria, $80. And Mokapan, $2.50. The trifecta, $108.15. $108.15 for the trifecta. And the Quinella is not yet available. We should have that very shortly. Fitzherbert the winner, $2.05.90. Centuria, $80. And Mokapan, $2.50. Quinella, $3.80. And the trifecta, $108.15. Bendigo, race 3, went to 7-4 dice, $125.65. Second, 1 Classic Move, $70. Third, 4 Proudly Bold, $85. Quinella, $140. Trifecta, $11.45.
Today's racing telecast is another Carlton Sporting coverage.
Go for the greatness.
8:50. Generally considered to be the hardest race to win in Australia, the Caulfield Cup provides not only one of the greatest tests of speed and stamina in racing, but also provides one of the finest spectacles in the sport of kings. The sight of 18 finely tuned thoroughbreds charging down this famous Caulfield straight is a sight to gladden the hearts of racing enthusiasts from all around the world who gather at the famous course in mid-October. Not only is the Cup one of the most famous races in the land, it's also one of the most sought after. So much so that way back in 1943, the race attracted so many entries that it was divided for the first and only time in its long and proud history. The legendary Scobie Breasley was aboard Skipton, which took out the second division of the race almost 2 years after his Melbourne Cup victory, while Harry White Sr., father of the present day jockey, piloted St. Warden to victory in the first division of the big event. One of the best horses ever to cross the Tasman was Rising Fast, the winner of the 1954 Caulfield Cup. The mighty horse from New Zealand was partnered by Arthur Ward when he took out the Cup in 54, and he would win the Melbourne Cup just a few weeks later. Rising Fast also won the Caulfield Cup in 1955 and was considered a certainty beaten when narrowly defeated by Toparoa in that year's Melbourne Cup. J.B. Cummings, or Bart as he's better known, took out the first of his 5 Caulfield Cups in 1966. The horse which afforded him that memorable victory was the striking Alcimedes gelding Galilee, which proved far too strong for Gala Crest. And like Rising Fast, he was to complete the big double on the first Tuesday in November. And while Galilee made his mark on Caulfield Cup history in 1966, a handsome 3-year-old named Sobar did the same 6 years later. After scoring an effortless win in the Caulfield Guineas the previous Saturday, Sobar was sent to the post a raging hot 2-1 favourite. And giving Harry White an armchair ride, the brilliant colt didn't let the punters down.
Sobar looked to be coasting, 2 lengths now to Sheriff.